乌克兰特种部队继续在库斯克州前进，强势压制俄军。 现场炮火密集，显见乌军确实有备而来。不止一路挺进工业区的建筑，现在占据的土地面积还在扩大当中。Українські
воїни продовжують захисну операцію у визначених районах Курської області. На сьогодні наші сили контролюють більше ніж 1250 квадратних кілометрів території ворога.
控制的聚落又增加到至少92个。另外，乌克兰也证实摧毁第三座库斯克州主要桥梁，还有俄军的浮桥也被炸烂，代表夹在中间的俄军都要面临被围困的风险。
The estimated area of the potential encirclement is almost 700 square kilometers. 27 settlements of the Kursk region may be blocked.
不止俄罗斯境内。 乌克兰边境苏梅地区也有迫击炮部队从远处支援，朝库斯克的俄军阵地发射一枚枚炮弹，前两枚也确实逼近俄军阵地。上头无人机直击到俄军，吓到连忙跑进树丛掩护。
We are working both day and night. I understand that this is to support our forces in Kursk.
And do you think your troops will push across this border into Russia? Or have you tried already? Have you tried to push into Russia yet?
If we receive orders, we'll go.
库斯克地区一间体育馆内满满都是临时的睡床。短短两个礼拜，已经有十多万边境居民被迫撤离到这里。Мы
двое суток шли. Трудно, что дроны нас не пускали, то падали. Дети с нами шли, многодетные, 8 человек.
镜头另一边还有许多长者得搭乘火车安置到其他更远的俄罗斯南部城市，因为俄罗斯边境状况百出，先前遭乌克兰无人机击中的罗斯托夫油槽火势到现在还无法完全控制。 现场共有11座油槽陷入火海，连消防员都束手无策。讽刺的是，事发当时俄罗斯总统普京宁可出访亚塞拜然。军事专家分析，普京有可能真的还想不出办法。
I think the Ukraine military calculated that this is what would happen if they were going to be successful. It was all in their risk analysis of doing this mission to begin, because it was very risky, no question about it. This could have failed miserably. And he's doing exactly what they're thinking now, and he's not going to respond with major strikes. He can't carpet bomb his own territory.
乌克兰能在边境顺利推进，归功细腻谋划。英国国防安全智库皇家联合军事研究所研究员就点出几个成功关键。从一开始的精确情报搜集，掌握俄军在该区的陷阱障碍物，并没有想象多后，就开始分析地理形势，思考进攻路线。中间也妥善使用西方军武和炮兵支援，进一步干扰俄军通讯。心理战方面，则是大量公布拍摄俄国村庄的路标，使敌军心生畏惧。 然而，乌东的状况却变得危急。随着俄罗斯宣称夺下另一个小镇后，也开始逼近波科罗夫斯克地区。乌克兰下令当地有小孩的家庭都要撤离。
I think in terms of the Eastern Front, it's clear that Moscow continues to devote a lot of energy. So I think the message Russia is sending there is that even though this has happened, their territory has been invaded in Kursk, they are not giving up on their goals in Ukraine.
乌东战况焦灼，但这个周末还是会有国际领袖访问乌克兰。
Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi will undertake an official visit to Ukraine later this week.
这不仅是莫迪在俄乌战后首次造访，也是印度和乌克兰建交30年以来首度有总理访问。过去印度因为购买俄国武器和石油，一直避免谴责俄国入侵。上个月还访问俄罗斯送暖，现在则改访问乌克兰，似乎是想担任调停的角色，尽早结束战争。野新闻综合报道。
想看最完整的新闻内容，记得下载 TVBS 新闻网 APP。